for you to renounce all this. But not immediate. First you have to lead the normal, natural way of life. Now then, when maturity, experience, knowledge, understanding appears in the mind, then reduce and reduce and reduce what you have accumulated. Third one, he says, ananna sukha, indebtedness. So when you come to know, you have not borrowed anything from anybody. You could manage to maintain by knowing your income and expenditure very carefully. So you are not indebted to anybody. That happiness also important. Self-respect. You are not indebted to anybody. You must have that in your mind. Last one is anavajya sukha, the guilty feeling in our mind. I have done this, I have done so much of damages, I have bluffed and simply, I have created violence. If there is no such feeling in our mind to maintain such guilty feeling, that happiness is greater than all the other three. Why? The other three gives happiness while we are living, but not hereafter. But the last happiness that maintain our mind without having any guilty feeling support us for our next existence. Because we depart from this world with hope and confidence. Because we know we have not done anything, any harm to anybody. There was a British Buddhist scholar in Australia, David Morris. He has written many Buddhist books also. So one day I received a letter from him. He has written, "Reverend Sir, I think you will be very happy to know that I died today." Then he says, "There are two reasons for you to be happy. As an old man who had been suffering very painful sicknesses, after my death I will be free from that pain. So you must be happy about that. Second reason, ever since that I accepted Buddhism." He was not a born Buddhist. "Ever since I accepted Buddhism, I tried my best not to violate, not to break any of the five precepts. So if there is another life hereafter, after our death, that life cannot become miserable." Now this is the second reason why we should be happy. This clearly shows he had full confidence that his next existence cannot become miserable. That is what this last happiness gives us confidence. So while we are living here, every day we are molding our next existence. Our thoughts, our words, our actions. So, when we are going to depart from this world, all those karmic energies that we have accumulated in the subconscious mind started to project. Now then, before our death, we catch and hold on one particular karmic energy, karmic thoughts. Now then, we birth. Next existence take place according to that karma that we have been holding. Now this is the nature of birth and death. So, without developing craving for others' things, without developing jealousy and what you call problems and troubles and discrimination, if we know how to look after our own property without craving for others enough, then one day we come to know this is a burden, this is a nuisance, I have no peace because of these things. Then try to hand over to their children, or not donate to them, charitable institute. The mind will be free from burdens and responsibilities. And this method was a very ancient Indian philosophy, clearly mentioned, dharma, artha, kama, moksha. The whole life divided into four periods, from the beginning up to the end. Dharma. First, we must learn discipline, our behavior, our way of life, to lead a gentle way of life. Otherwise, everything will be upset. That means when we are young, we have to learn all these things. Discipline, how to behave, what to do, what not to do, morals and immorals. First period. Then the second period. Artha. Artha means earning. So you can start your business, whatever you like, to earn. It is natural, it is important. No one can say it is wrong. The second period of your life, you have to spend for earning by doing something. Then you are preparing your way of life. Why? You must have opportunities to experience sensual pleasure. Without any income, if you start to enjoy your worldly life, you get into trouble. Therefore, very systematically introduce this. First, you must learn discipline, behavior, character. After that, you have to work. You have to do something. So when you got something enough, then you can enjoy your life. Reasonably. Dharma, artha, kama. Then, now getting old, you had to forget your business, your sensual pleasure, you have seen, you have done, that is enough. Then start a new life. What is that? You have to think very seriously, there will be another existence for me. Time has come for me to depart from here to start a new life, another life. Therefore, I had to prepare for this. Forget about all this business, all this, what you call pleasure. Have free mind by reducing anger, enmity, jealousy, ill will, grudge, and reduce, throw all this rubbish. Have free mind. Don't develop too much of attachment toward your property. Hand over. Then your mind will be free. So one day, we will be able to say goodbye peacefully, without fear, without worries, without suspicion, without confusion, with hope and confidence, we can depart from this world. Then start to build another one. This is the way how Buddha has introduced. So when we say, craving is the main cause of all our suffering, it is true. But we must know how to differentiate what are the craving that which create our suffering. What are the things that we need for our survival, for our duties, our responsibilities. Then we can tackle this problem. Again, Buddha says, you must have four more great qualities. What are those? Arakka sampada, ఉత్థాన సంప్రదా కళ్యాణ